Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial I want to share 15 mini tips and tricks with you that I think are really handy. Some of them are really simple, some of them are slightly more advanced, but I'll just try to go over them as quickly as possible to just give you some really cool ideas. I will also make sure to link out to some of the examples in the description below, and also if you have any questions about any of the tips that I'm about to share, then just let me know in the comments below as well. So let's just dive right in. So then tip number one, so the first tip is to use some keyboard shortcuts inside the flow builder. So what you can do, you can for example press shift to select multiple items. So let's say these two, and then you can copy them by pressing command C, or if you're on Windows with control C, and then you would paste them with control V or command V, and then you basically have a duplicate. Now you can also do this by copying and pasting blocks inside another flow, or even pasting them inside another bot. So I think that is pretty cool. What you can also do if you just want to make a duplicate of a block inside a flow, you can just press Option on Mac or Alt on Windows to make a duplicate right here like I'm doing right now. So then tip number two, and it is that you should plan out your flows before you start building them. So just create a simple list of all the flows that you want to create and also the order that you want people to go through. So for example, I created the Facebook Messenger bot. So then people first go through a little welcome message, then they go through my segmentation process, then I deliver the download that they requested, then I capture an email address, then I invite them for my free course, then they follow the free course, then I invite them for my webinar, and then I pitch my product. And that is basically my Facebook Messenger bot with all the steps that people have to go through before they become a customer. And I have the feeling if you just write it out for yourself, it becomes way easier to build out your bot. So then tip number three, and it is to segment new subscribers right after they subscribed to your bot so that you can personalize their experience. So this is how I'm doing that. I would ask a couple of questions. So here the first question is, what kind of products or services do you sell? Digital products, physical products, or services? So these are quick replies, and as soon as someone clicks one of these quick replies, then they go into an action where I store that answer into a user field. So this user field is called segment-product type. Then I go over to the next question, and this question depends on what they previously answered. So if they just said digital product, then I ask, cool, what kind of digital product are you selling? Now, then they have another few quick replies again. So if they would say online courses, then I store online courses into another custom field, and this one is called segment-product. Then I go over to the next one, and then I ask what people find most difficult right now. Is that to grow your list, convert subscribers, or getting started? So if they would say convert subscribers, then inside a custom field called segment-struggle, I store convert subscribers. And then last but not least, I ask how I can help people best. So after people ask these four really simple questions, I already know what kind of product they sell, exactly which product they sell, what kind of help they need, and also what their biggest struggle is. And then I can use that to personalize the conversation. So then tip number four is to collect email addresses in Messenger from your subscribers so that you can also reach out to people outside of Messenger. So for example, when the messaging window is closed, so when you're not allowed to send messages anymore. So this is how I'm doing it. So I have some kind of incentive that I give away in exchange for an email address. So in this case, it is the Chapel checklist. So I always start with some kind of visual teaser of the download. Then I personalize the messages based on the answers that they gave me earlier. So if they, for example, said that they sell online courses, then they say here, I created a checkbot checklist that will help you to build a better messenger bot so you can sell more online courses. And then I set the expectation that I'm going to ask for an email address. So I ask, shall I send it to you by email, Max? Now, if they then say, yes, please, then I check, do I already have the email address? Because if I already have it, I'm not going to ask for it again. But if I don't have it yet, then I have a user input here in which I ask for people their email address. So I also have a separate tutorial about this, how you do this, and also you deliver a lead magnet then. So be sure to check that out. Tip number five, and it is that you should really know the Messenger platform policies. So there are quite a lot of different policies, And I know it's not super exciting to learn these things and to go through all these materials, but it's extremely important that you know when you're allowed to send a message, what kind of messages you're allowed to send, because you really do not want to break any of these policies, because then you risk that Facebook is limiting your page from sending messages to your subscribers. So I'll also make sure to put a link out to this in the description below. Tip number 6, and this one is slightly more advanced, but I think it's quite exciting, so I wanted to show it to you anyway. And this is that you should create maybe some kind of master automation that is basically checking what people already received and what they should receive next. So you see over here that I have my flows. So I have my welcome message, my mini interview, my lead magnet delivery, my smart email capture, my invitation for my free course, and then basically the end of this, which says like, hey, have a great day. And how this works is that you have a condition, and in this condition, you basically check, did this person already finish this flow? So you see here that I say tag is not event finished welcome message. So if you go over here inside my welcome message, and then in the end, you will see that I add a tag that says event finished welcome message. And then we go back into this master automation that I call the content loop. So then next time they will go over here. So then they basically don't match these first things because they have this tag. So they will not get the welcome message anymore. And then they go to the next thing. Tag is not finished mini interview. So the mini interview is the segmentation process that I showed you earlier. And then in the end of that, I add a tag that says finished onboarding. And then we go back into the content loop. And then inside the content loop, it will now not send the welcome message, not send the mini interview. And then it will check, okay, did this person opt in for a specific download? If yes, so if this field has any value, then I'm going to my lead magnet delivery selector, basically. So it's slightly more advanced. I will not go too deep into this, but I just want to give you an overview of how this works, right? And after that, I check, okay, is the email address unknown? And did this person not receive my chatbot checklist yet? Then go into the smart email capture where I capture an email address. And then they go back into the content loop. So back into my master automation. So they always go back in here. And then I check, okay, did this person already finish my free course? Are they not currently following my free course? Or did they say that they're not interested in my free course? If they all do not have these tags, then they go into my free course invitation. And then in the end of that, so after someone finished the whole master automation, so the whole content loop, then they go to this red line, which is content loop end. And in here I say basically, that's it for now. Have a great Friday. So this is my tip about the master automation. I think this is really cool. Tip number 7. So I think it's really important that you add a clear call to action to your greeting text. So your greeting text is the text that people see before they click the get started button. So for example, after they click the messenger ref URL, they will see a window like this before they opt in to your Facebook messenger bot. So I think it's really important that you really make it clear that people should click the button below to get started. So I'm using this for all my pages and I have the feeling it works really well. So one thing to mention is that I say click the button below instead of click get started, because this button automatically translates to the language of the subscriber. So make sure you set the greeting text. You can find it under settings and then under general, and then at the top you will find your greeting text. Tip number 8, and it is about the default reply, and it is that you should be very intentional about what you want to do with this flow. Because this flow gets sent to subscribers who type something that the bot doesn't know a reply to. So it's basically an unexpected user input from the subscriber. So I know that most people set it up like this, that the subscriber gets a message, sorry, I didn't get that, so I forward you to one of the admins. And then people can click yes, thanks. Then you mark the conversation as open with an action. And then you also notify yourself or someone else from the team. And then you say, ok, done. But I actually really like to disable this, because I think it's a bit silly when people get a message like this, that they maybe just send an emoji, the default reply triggers, and then they get a message like this. I don't think that's a super good user experience. So yeah, my tip is think about if you need the default reply at all. If not, just disable it. And if you need it, then make sure to modify it to something really great. Tip number 9, and this one is about how you should name your tags. So I think it's really important that you stick to a certain kind of naming convention, because otherwise things can get really messy. So what I recommend doing, so this is what I'm doing also, is that you put the category of the kind of tag that it is basically at the beginning, then the subcategory after it, then colon, and then what the specific thing is. So here you see that someone is interested in the topic Facebook ads. Here you, for example, see that there was an event. Someone answered question 1. Here is a webinar. So it's webinar related. Someone attended, and then the name of the webinar. Or here, sales, purchased, and then the name of the product. Or here, sales, refunded, the name of the product. And so on and so on. So this is my tagging framework. So I recommend that you create something like this for yourself inside Excel or inside Google Sheets. So I will also make sure to link out to this in the description box below so that you can just import it and change to your own needs. Tip number 10, and it is that you should remove tags as soon as they have served their purpose so that you can keep your subscriber's profile clean, but so that you can also reuse the same tag again inside a different flow. So whenever you add a tag, maybe to go a different path in the flow later on, be sure to remove that tag again. So then the subscriber's profile keep like nice and neat. And then you can also reuse the same tag again for that same person in maybe another flow. Tip 11, and this one is about the refresh permissions button. It's a really simple tip, but if you ever experience some kind of bug before you do anything else, just hit the refresh permissions button. You can find it under help. And then over here, if you click this, then the connection between ManyChat and Facebook will refresh. And sometimes this helps you out with the bug that you're experiencing. Tip 12, and this one is about how you can avoid the subscribers are getting stuck when they type something instead of clicking one of the quick replies. So that works like this. So what you're going to need is a user input multiple choice. So by doing this, you create a user input, and a user input will always wait for a reply from the subscriber before it continues. And because you use multiple choice, there will be quick replies inside your user input. So if you have regular quick replies, and when someone types something, then they're basically getting stuck. The bot will not continue. But when you use user input multiple choice, and then when somebody would type something here, then they're going to get a retry message if the answer was invalid. So if somebody would type here, la la la, or whatever they would type, then they would get a message that says, sorry, I didn't get that. Click one of the quick replies below, and then they would get those replies again. So be sure to check that out. I also created a separate tutorial about this with all the possibilities because I think it is so cool. Tip number 13. So sometimes you really want people to continue a flow. You do not want them to get distracted. But obviously people are on Facebook, they will get distracted. So what you can do, you can use smart delays to send quick follow-ups. And this is how that works. So here, for example, this is a part of my welcome message where I tell people that all these messages are automated and that they can always unsubscribe by typing stop. Then I ask, is that okay? So I really want people to continue here. So if they do not continue within 4 minutes, I'm going to send them a follow-up. I'm going to say, don't be shy, just click OK below to continue. Now, how does that work? So as soon as someone clicks OK, so the quick reply, then a tag will be added to their profile that says event clicked OK. So at the same time, when we send this message, we automatically continue into a smart delay. We wait 4 minutes, and then after those 4 minutes, we check if the subscriber has this tag. So if the subscriber has that tag, then we know that they clicked this quick reply because otherwise they would not have the tag. So what we do then is we remove the tag because it has served its purpose. Remember, I said that in a previous tip. And then if they do not have that tag, then we know that they did not continue yet. So then we say, don't be shy, just click OK below to continue. OK, and then it would continue again. You do not add the tag again. And then we just continue the flow. And this is a really great method to keep subscribers engaged really shortly, but you want to make sure that you don't want to do this too often because it can also be a bit annoying. Tip 14. So ManyChat is improving their tool all the time. They're releasing new features, they're simplifying things, they're changing the flow builder. Like, they're really often rolling out new updates. So what I recommend you to do is that once in a while, so maybe every 2 weeks, every month, whenever you feel like it, that you go over to help and that you go to the public change log, because then you can see a list of all the changes that they made. And then maybe from that you get some ideas. You're like, hey, cool, there's this new feature, I can maybe implement this. Or they released another feature that makes your life easier, that you're like, hey, I can simplify this flow, this and this and that way. So that's why I really like to check the change log once in a while. And then the last tip, tip 15, is to ask questions and collect feedback from your subscribers so that you can get an ideas, but that you can also maybe improve your Facebook Messenger bot. So what you can do, you can just use a couple of user inputs to ask a couple of questions. So here I would, for example, say something like, hey Max, can I ask you a few questions so that I can create better content for you? So if they say, sure, no problem, then I say, ok, awesome, try to answer every question in one sentence. That way I can easily store it to review later, which is true. And then we have a couple of user inputs. So here we would say, question one, what is your favorite kind of dot, dot, dot? Question two, would you rate it dot, 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 or dot, dot, dot? How would you rate my content right now from 1 to 10? 1 is good, 10 is bad. And then I have a couple of quick replies that they can click. And then the next question, how would you describe dot, dot, dot in one sentence? So you can just create a really simple survey, and I get really amazing results and also amazing ideas from this, because so many people are actually completing these surveys because they do not even have to leave Messenger for it. So this is a quick tip I wanted to give you. I'll also make sure to link out to this flow in the description below. So those were my 15 best ManyChat tips and tricks that I wish I would have known when I just got started with ManyChat. So I hope this helped you and that it gave you some inspiration of showing you what is possible. If you have any questions about any of the tips that I just showed you, just ask it in the comments below. I will try to answer every question. And if you maybe have an idea for a tip that you think should really have been in this video, then also make sure to leave a comment. I would really love that. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, then make sure to hit that subscribe button.